Want to find a girlfriend this autumn? Well, I can't help you with the date and the rest, but I can definitely help you for your fragrance. So grab your coffee and let's go. Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. This is Clémence. I talk about fragrance and welcome back. In today's video, I got you 5 of my all-time favorite fragrance for men. Super sexy. See, if you want to go on a date, you want to impress the lady and you want to make her melt a little bit, I took 5 of the one that I know that I really love on men. Number one, and it's a designer fragrance that I got to retry recently and really love it. In there. Oh yeah, this is quite cool actually, by Micro Perfume. They're doing those little refill and you can try some different fragrance in there. So I really recommend for you to have a try, especially like if you want to have like travel version of your favorite designer and stuff. It does look a bit like advertising, but it's actually not. I've got Armani Code Profumo. I've done a video on that, so if you want to have a look, it's there. Armani Code Profumo is, for me, one of the most sexiest fragrances I've ever smelled on a man. A lot of men will say, oh my god, it's a little bit too sweet. And I'm just like, yes, but that's what women love nowadays. Tastes are changing, it's like fashion. We like to have a richer composition. And this is perfect. There's a rich and intense tonkabin scent, so nearly vanilla like that. Kind of like overpowering in there, and we love that. It's so sweet, it's sexy, and the sillage with this one, and I think for me, compared to all the range, this is the most powerful. It leaves something behind you. Really affordable, a great value with the result that is coming with it. It's cardamom, it makes it nearly yummy. Do you want to smell yummy? There we go. Enjoy. It's been a long time I didn't talk about this fragrance, but if I'm talking about something sexy, classy at the same time, how can I not talk about this baby here? One of my favorite fragrances ever, first of all. You won't regret this purchase ever. It's Grand Soir by Maison Francis Coeur Jean. Did I say it well? I think I did. Classy and refinement in a bottle, making yourself attractive without shouting at the girl's face. Something I know about women, because I am one. In my world, I don't like when a guy is overshowing. This is maybe a bit much. Show your masculinity, show a bit of sensuality, but not shout about it, because this is sending the wrong message, just to let you know, because it shows, okay, maybe I won't be able to trust this guy. Because if he does that with me, maybe he's doing that with other girls. Grand Soir is purely one of the best amber fragrances I've ever smelled. Sensuality, waxy tone, mysterious tone, because amber always like match with some incense and stuff like that. It's part of the oriental vibe, and all this oriental vibe give always a super seductivity, but also some mystery. It's simply amber and a lot of vanilla, not a sickening vanilla. Okay, you're going to something really classy, but you want to have that sexism. For example, if I'm going to a very fancy restaurant, I would probably wear Profumo. That would be something for a slightly sexier date. This is the dinner, the cocktail party. This is where you want to show off all your classiness, gentleman vibes, not too heavy. So it makes you feel comfortable as well as the other person. Winner. Always my winner. My favorite fragrance ever. Floris Honeywood. I don't know how many times somebody like called me on their fragrance channel to ask me what was my favorite scent on a man. And I said Honeywood. Underrated. The essence of that British charm, the gentleman they are usually known for, not the hooligan. For me, Floris, you can compare it to Chanel. Even if it's oud and it's honey, it's not sticky and it's not animalic. That's it, it says it all. It's balanced to a level of perfection that is incredible. The honey is there to make it like a bit addictive. It's not something that would be very sticky. And the oud is there to give like a darkness, a backbone, some sexy touch, but again, not overpowering. You can wear that all year long. It's so charming. It's really so charming. Like, I feel like I'm a woman. As a French woman, I went to the UK, you know, to find some kind of a James Bond kind of thought, well, there he is, that's it, that's exactly that. Still didn't find it, but you can't imagine how I'm dreaming of a man that I'm going on a date that would say I'm wearing a honey hood. I'd be like, oh my god, marry me. Next one is probably the most sultry, sensual and sexual one.
What?
Tobacco Nuit Atelier Cologne. Just the most addictive fragrance I've ever smelled on a man. And I've got experience twice with this fragrance. I actually went on a date twice with two different guys.
What?
Not at the same time. That was wearing Tobacco Nuit. The first one, I didn't actually know he was wearing it. And he was like, oh, what do you think? And so I was like, oh my god, you smell amazing. Like, what is that? And I was like sticking to his skin and be like, sorry. The guy was not the most exciting I've seen. But when I was smelling it, I was just like, oh my god. The tobacco is so smoky, overpowering. I'd say this is the most strongest out of all the fragrances I have. If you want to fill in the room, if you want to have that sillage, if you want to impress that girl that never look at you, you just go next to her, she will definitely see you. 100%. This is also probably the most risky of the list. I think you need to smell it before, because it's something that is really unique, very different, and can be very dark for some people. Maybe a bit too much, try, but you won't regret it. This is just lots of spiciness. And that's why I think it's so exciting. There's so much spice. Cumin, coriander, things like that, that give you that very spicy feeling. I don't know how to explain it. And finally, my last one is Rehab by Initio Parfum Privé. You would say, oh, how come it's sexy? Let me tell you something. Romanticism is the new sexy. Cuddles, man. Like, the cuddles is the new sexy. With this one, the only thing you have to remember that is quite woody. So you have a lot of vetiver, but it doesn't smell green. It's more that woody touch, slightly smoky, that cedar, so quite a sharp wood, some sandalwood. And sandalwood is more present in there. So what does give sandalwood? It gives creaminess, softness, that mellow touch. You've got also a lot of lavender. So it's at the same time relaxing, but with a lot of character. And overall, the fragrance is ultra powdery. Powdery fragrance always give like a very strong sillage around you without being harassing, attacking you. This fragrance is so round, so cocooning, so powdery that every time I smell it, I want to cuddle it. So I do wear that a lot myself. So I would say it's the most unisex of the range. I'm just dreaming of a man wearing that. It's so cuddly. Like, I just want to cuddle it when I smell it. It's romantic and at the same time very sexy. And for fall, I think it's ideal to get that very powdery touch. So I highly recommend you to have a try. It's not for the dinner at the restaurant, this one. It's more like when you go home or you're having a Netflix and chill with a girl and you want to give that vibe. Well, this is the one. She's gonna stick to you, trust me. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please tell me, girls, help those men. And ladies, let's please put in the comments what is the fragrance that for you drive you mad this fall. And I will talk to you very, very soon. Please subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed yet. And leave a little like and share the video. And too much asking. Okay, too much asking. Thank you for my uTipper, like the person that always tipped me on uTip. I love you. Thank you so much. And I will see you very soon. Bye now. Viens, je t'emmène dans mon paradis bleu.